please do the roll call.
Robert Smith.
Here.
Maria Zapaznik.
Here.
Lori Sapeda.
Here.
Noah Carston.
Here.
Thomas Lima.
Here.
Brittany Frazoka.
Here.
Leandro Alvarez.
Here.
Gilbert Carreras. Jane Krellin.
Here.
Megan Fisk.
Here.
Connor Gerlach.
Here.
Nicori Saridia.
Here.
Emma Holman.
Here.
Patrick Hurd.
Here.
Joshua Locke. Linda Lynn. Logan Roush. Jose Rosario.
Here.
Ken Salhany.
Here.
Derek Trombley. Jason Windrow.
Here.
Scott Keane.
Here.
Michelle Brophy Bierman. Mark Paolucci. Robert Santori.
Here.
Please rise and pledge allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Okay, I'm now seeking a motion for the approval of the agenda. Your motion, motion by Representative Salhany, second by Representative Fisk. Any discussion on the agenda?
May I add something to the agenda, Mr. Speaker?
Yes.
New item six, new business for the campus safety awareness resolution I presented to everyone. And that would make constitutions and conference reports, item seven, reports item eight, and so on and so forth. Down the line.
Okay, is there a second to this motion? Second by Treasurer Paulson. Any discussion on the amendment to the agenda? Hearing none, all those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, no. Abstentions? And the agenda and the amendment passes. Is there any further discussion on tonight's agenda? Hearing none, we now move to a vote. All those in favor of approving the agenda as amended, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, no. Abstentions, and the agenda is approved. We now move to item three, approval of minutes of October 28th, 2015. Is there any discussion on these minutes? I'm seeking a motion to approve the minutes of October 28th, 2015. Motion by Representative Rosario, second by Vice President Any further discussion? Hearing none, we now move to a vote. All those in favor of approving the minutes of October 28th, 2015, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, no. Abstentions, and the minutes are approved. We now move on to open forum. Is there anyone here for open forum? Is there anyone here for open forum? Is there anyone present for open forum? Hearing none, I now declare the open forum closed. We now move to item five, officers' announcements. Item A, President Robert Smith.
Hello. I don't really have much today. I'm speaking twice more today. I just want you guys to know that we have, in fact, now signed a contract with the library for the extended library hours. Those of you who don't know, the library is open a few hours earlier and open a few hours later from now until, I believe, the week before final exams. The reason for this is we had the library last time, we had 24 hours during 2 weeks for exams, keep a track of who was entering the library and who was actually studying in the library. And they found that between the hours of like 2 a.m. and 6 a.m., no one was really studying. Most students were just there sleeping, which is not what the library is supposed to be used for. And most of the feedback we've always gotten from this actual body in previous years is the fact that everyone wishes the library just had longer hours, usually around the time for midterms to around final exams to help everyone, because after all, it's not just the final exams that everyone has to study for or work on. We all have final papers, final projects, all which require the resources of the library. So we pay for that, and that's really all I have. I'll be talking again later today. Thanks, guys.
All right, thank you. Item B, Vice President Maria Zapaznik.
I just want to say hi to everybody again, even though we've only started doing this last week. So much has happened in that time, and I look forward to getting to some important issues on campus. Thank you.
All right, thank you. Item C, Secretary Lori Sapeda.
So I just want to remind you, all of you that are part of other clubs, that the next roundtable is November 18th. The email for that will be going out at the end of this week. It's going to be in the ballroom during free period, and I hope you all like the invitations. I have a few more that I need to pass out at the end of the meeting, and I hope you can all RSVP by November 25th, and that I'll see your lovely faces at the holiday club. Thank you.
All right, thank you. Treasurer Noah Goss.
Hi guys. I want to say hello. We have new members sitting down at the end of the table. Other than that, keep your eye out, and the email will be going out soon. It's almost budget process time, everyone's favorite time of the year for everyone on the eboard of your clubs. Other than that, I am also talking a few more times this meeting, so talk to you soon.
All right, thank you. Now for my announcements, I have several leaves tonight. We'll take them one at a time. First is from Derek Promley. Dear Speaker Lima, I cannot make tonight's meeting due to the commitment to Greek 101. Thank you, Representative Promley. Is there a motion to approve the leave? Motion by Representative Rosario, second by President Smith. Discussion? Hearing no discussion, all those in favor of approving the leave, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, no. Abstentions, and the leave is approved. We now move on to a leave from Representative Gilbert Carruthers. Dear Speaker Lima, I'm sending this email to inform you that I will not be able to attend the Parliament meeting on November 4th. This is due to the fact that I am required to attend the Greek 101 meeting that day. Thank you for your time. Sincerely, Gilbert Carreras. I'm now seeking a motion for approval. Motion by Representative Fisk, second by Representative Rosario. Any discussion on the leave? Hearing none, all those in favor of approving the leave, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, no. Abstentions, and the leave is approved. Next leave is from Representative Lynn. Hello. Fortunately, I cannot make it to Parliament tonight because I will be attending the Festival of Lights event. Please excuse my absence. Best regards, Linda Lynn. Is there a motion to approve? Motion by Representative Trellin, second by Vice President Sapasnik. Any discussion on the leave? Hearing none, we now move to a vote. All those in favor of approving the leave, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, no. Abstentions, and the leave is approved. Lastly, a leave from Representative Locke. Dear Speaker Lemur and fellow Parliament members, I had an unexpected schedule conflict come up tonight, so I will unfortunately be able to, it says, I'll read it as it says, so I will unfortunately be able to make it tonight to tonight's Parliament meeting. Sincerely, Joshua Locke. Is there any, I'm seeking a motion to approve this leave. Motion by Treasurer Costin, second by Representative Sahani. Any discussion on this leave? Hearing none, we now move to a vote. Type will include it on this leave. All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, no. Abstentions, and the leave is approved. And that concludes my announcements. We'll move on to Deputy Speaker Brittany Pazoko.
Hey everybody, I have a town hall meeting November 18th during free period in Donovan Dining. I'm hoping all of you can attend and help us get like stuff from our peers. I have a reminder to my committee, we have a meeting tomorrow night at 6 p.m. And I also have a resignation to read, and it says, I, Brittany Pazoko, am resigning from the position of Deputy Speaker effectively at the end of the semester due to academic conflicts. I still look forward to serving as a member of the body next semester.
Could I say something, Mr. Speaker?
Yes.
With her resignation, what happens now is we have a declaration period. For those who are around at the end of last semester, how it usually works is we have a sign-up sheet in the office. I just ask Joanne about it if you're interested. So our declaration period is going to be from November 17th to December 1st. The election meeting will be on the meeting of December 2nd, which I believe is our last Parliament meeting of the year. So how it's going to work is we'll have an election meeting at 7:15 p.m. And then once we finish that election meeting, with whoever signs up. Usually how it works is those who have signed themselves up to run for Deputy Speaker will make speeches. We have a round or two of voting. We'll have a brief 15-minute recess, and then we'll resume with the actual meeting. So we'll actually have two meetings on December 2nd, with the election one starting at 7:15, and the normal meeting to resume whenever it happens to be, probably around 7:45 or 8 o'clock. So if you're interested in running for Brittany's position, come talk to me and anyone else in the e-board or Brittany to find out what it's like, and put your name out for starting November 17th. That's all I have, Mr. Speaker. Thank you.
All right, thank you. That's a concluding announcement.
That concludes all I have.
We now move on to item six, new business, campus safety resolution, President Smith.
Okay, so what you have in front of you guys is a resolution I made. I found my stand. I had Joan proofread it, so we should be on spelling out right. I got a news alert on my smartphone today around the time I was in finance about there was this college in California where 5 people were stabbed. And it seems the longer I have a smartphone and I get sent news apps is that it seems more and more that on-campus violence is happening. So I wrote this resolution mostly to make us all aware of the fact that even though we actually, Rick is actually one of, I think, the top 10 safest schools in New England, that campus safety is something we should all be aware of. So I just like to read it very briefly. It reads, whereas Rhode Island College is located in an urban area situated among two urbanized areas, it's probably redundancy, but we'll ignore that. Whereas there are approximately 9,000 students, faculty, staff, and other workers who utilize this campus during the work week, so that includes, you know, people like Dr. Kane and Mark and Dr. Wilfred Behrman, who aren't here right now. Where there are students, faculty, staff, administration, and campus visitors, all have a right to a fully functional and safe environment to learn, perform jobs, and other duties on campus. Be therefore resolved that SCG Inc. endorses and recommends that this body promotes campus safety as an issue. Campus safety and awareness is not just the job of the campus police. It's up to everyone to promote safe practices in a safe learning environment. Be it further resolved that this body recognizes the need for more hands-on student-driven awareness in this age of college violence. So I thought I would bring this issue before the body in a form of a resolution. I'm open to any questions or discussion. I know a few ideas have been floated among the body of what we can do. I've heard ideas like perhaps doing a blind test of the blue emergency lights on campus to see what exactly is the reaction time of campus police and how effective they are. Mr. Speaker, if it's okay, I'd like to open the floor to any questions.
Yes, first I need a motion. A second. The motion is from you. The second is by Deputy Speaker Rizzoco. And now we make a convened discussion. Pass the floor back to you, Mr. President.
I have a question. I'm unaware because I've never actually seen someone use one of the lights, which I guess is a good thing because I'm causing them. But I was under the impression, and I believe I was told during my freshman orientation, that it also reaches out to Providence Police.
I don't know.
I don't know if that's true or not, but if it is, if we do a blind test, then we might be smart.
No, we would obviously not find that. And Deputy Gill, should we do something like that? But I'm open to all the next suggestions to make the campus safe.
Right, the floor is still open for discussion. Deputy Speaker Rizzoco.
Something that's been brought up by my committee members in several of my meetings is when they walk around campus, it's not enough lighting, so they don't necessarily feel safe. So I think that's a big issue, especially in residence halls and by the gym way over there. Yes, it's well lit, but it could be more well lit so you can see in every direction around you in case someone was to come up behind you or from another area.
All right, any further discussion on the resolution? Hearing none, we now move to a vote to approve the resolution. All those in favor of approving the resolution, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, no. Abstentions, and the resolution is approved. We now move on to item 7A under Constitutions and Organization Conference Reports. WXIN Conference Report, Robert Smith.
Hi again, it's me doing more talking. So I'm also the general manager of 90.7 WXIN, for those of you who don't, should I get up?
Yeah, I think it'll be, that's a set for the show.
I can take you, what do you want me to say? Anyone?
Okay.
Actually, I'll see how we feel at the actual clubs.
So 90.7 WXIN, for those of you who don't know, I'm also the general manager of the college's radio station. We went to a conference in New York called CMJ, it stands for College Music Journal. This is a bit of an old person thing, but before Spotify and Pandora, how you found out new music was always through college radio stations. A CMJ is the larger organization that charts that and keeps track of what's popular, what's now, what's playing, what are people listening to. So it's part of a larger network of college radio stations, marketing companies, record labels, everything to do with the music industry. We go down for about 5 days, and we're of course very grateful that it's partially funded, as is SXN, and we get something from our own pocket. We go down for 5 days to New York City, where we hear new bands, mingle with record labels, college radio stations, commercial radio stations, and I'm actually very proud to announce that we won our first ever conference award for biggest champions of the local music scene. Robbie, did you bring anybody? We also, it wasn't an actual award, they gave us a poster and about 20 of these hoodies, so if you could just look over Robbie. Third decade is going strong and being awarded for its hard work. And I'm open to any questions from the body about the conference and what we've done.
All right, is there a motion to approve the conference report? Motion by Representative Grillin, second by Vice President Pasnik. Discussion. Any discussion or questions for the representative? Hearing none, we now move on to a vote. All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, no. Abstentions. Representative Hurd and President Smith abstain. And conference report is approved. We now move on to item 8 on the agenda. Reports A, Finance Commission minutes of October 28th, 2015. Treasurer Collins.
Hello, everyone. These minutes were approved by my Finance Commission, and I ask that they be accepted with unanimous consent.
Is there any objection to the minutes being approved with unanimous consent? Hearing none, the minutes are approved. Item B, General Fund Report, Treasurer Costa.
Okay, hi guys. So this is kind of new for me too. So this is the first General Fund Report I'm putting out for this year. For those of you that don't know, SCG operates by receiving the student activities fee that all undergraduate students pay, which we then call the General Fund. So the General Fund is how we fund student organizations. When you see the Finance Commission meetings, all the money that's being allocated or reallocated originally came from the General Fund, and each club is given an operating budget based out of the General Fund. So this is sort of the report of how it's gone so far. I just would like to draw attention to the breakdown of the Finance Commission allocation report. You see the expenditures for educational trips, conferences, operating budgets, and other allocations. I think it's a really great thing that our clubs are going on conferences, and we're setting out new operating budgets. We've had 4 or 5 new clubs come this year, get approved their constitutions, and then come for operating budgets so they can start, you know, settling themselves into RIC, and it's a great promotion of student life and everything, so I'm very proud to see that. If anyone has any questions on these or friendly amendments or anything possible I might have missed, please feel free.
All right, would you like this to be approved with unanimous consent?
Yes, please.
All right, is there any discussion before we move? All right. Are there any objection to this report being accepted with unanimous consent? Hearing none, the report is approved. Now move on to item 9 already. Updates and remarks. A administration update.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Just a couple of things. One, I want to give you all a little bit of a construction update since some time has passed since the last time I did that. Construction on campus, that is. And you all know, of course, that Gage Hall, we're not using it this semester because we had received a general obligation bond from the state to renovate that building and Craig Lee over the next many years. And last May, or probably even last March, as we were trying to project out when construction would start with Gage, we believed it would happen by the beginning of this academic year. And so obviously we couldn't have anybody in the building, no classes scheduled in there, or no faculty offices. Today it's what, November 4th, and it looks like probably from your vantage point that construction has not yet begun in the building, and you would be right in that assessment. What's going on right now is that the college had received some bids to do the work on both Gage and Craig Lee to do the renovations from a number of different companies, you know, competitive bids, just like you receive when you're trying to purchase things for student government or for your clubs and organizations. And so we received our competitive bids. The college had to go through a process by which to select an architect. We selected one, and it has been approved now by the Department of Administration. But there were a number of different things that happened along the way that slowed that process down and may continue to slow it down as we go forward. But we don't have actually written approval from the Department of Administration with respect to the architect, so we're going to need that. But we do have the verbal approval of who that architect is going to be. I don't know who it is. I'm sorry. This is just information that I've heard. But the bottom line is that whole process continues to evolve and move forward just at a slower pace than what we were obviously hoping. separate project that's happening, that construction has begun, and you have probably seen signs of a smaller project, is the addition onto the Fogarty Life Sciences building. Again, that was one of that was planned last March, at about the same time that we were working on the plans for Gage. And I think, you know, because that project is of smaller scope, it was easier to navigate the process with that project. And, you know, get the competitive bids, select the architect, and begin the work and get all the approvals necessary. But we continue to move forward. If we're fortunate to be able to stay on schedule, our hope would be that by the fall of 2017, Gage would be reopened. And then sometime after that, we would take Craig Lee offline, move everybody out of Craig Lee, and start the construction on that project. I do think that the fall of 2017 timeline, given the late start of the Gage project, for it to be done by the fall of 2017 at this point is probably optimistic. But, you know, there's a lot of time between now and then, and a number of things can be done to make up some time, just like there are a number of things can be done to slow the project down. But in any case, you know, we're moving along, and hopefully that you'll all get to see the fruits of that labor during your time here at Rhode Island College. Unless you're a senior, then you're much to graduate. The other much briefer announcement is just that you may know, if you don't, it's always good for the body to discuss this, that years ago, student community government under very, very different leadership, and when I say years ago, I'm talking about, I don't know what, maybe 20 years ago, a different group of students actually purchased a timeshare in New Hampshire on Loon Mountain, which has really been, for future administrations of the student government, has been sort of a bane, because you know, how do you equitably use a timeshare that can, I don't know, house 4 or 8 people, whatever, it's a very, very small number, and how do you get rid of it? That's the big question, is how you get rid of it. So Treasurer Karsten and myself will be meeting tomorrow to begin that process, try to once again sort of restart. We uncovered a couple of leads this summer, so we're a little bit more optimistic than we have been in the past about how to sell the condo. It costs student government money every year. You have to pay your annual maintenance fee. And so at this point, even if student government did not recover the amount of money that it spent to purchase the timeshare, in the long run, it would likely be worth just being able to sort of get out from underneath that issue and sort of move forward. We'll be able to give you an update in a few weeks about kind of where we stand with that.
Thank you, Dr. Kane. Update, Dr. B. Fairman is not here. Staff update, Mr. Mark Paolucci is not here. Alumni update, Robert Centurio Jr.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. So hey guys, hope everyone's doing well. This is the last meeting a week ago. Just a couple things I'd like to add this week. I know midterms happened, or some still happening for some of you. Hope you guys have a good work-life balance during that time. Remember, if things get a little too hard, there's always a counseling center for you guys on campus, among other resources. For a second, I'm really, really happy to see something that the library hours deal actually went through. Something that I know I worked on last year with last year's e-board and other people was trying to get library hours changed so more students, so I was really happy to see that. And also really especially happy here with the timeshare, possibly something happening with that. I know as president that was one of the banes of my existence, and trying to sell that was a giant pain. And just like that too, to what President Smith said earlier, is Deputy Speaker is a great opportunity for anyone who's really interested in student community government being more involved and not looking at a heavier basis, but getting an idea of really what they do on a day-to-day basis. So if you're interested in the position, definitely talk to them on the e-board and talk to Brittany about what the job does. But it does a lot of good things here on this campus, especially conditional services, which kind of ties into resolution tonight on campus safety, which you know, in President Smith's resolution is very, very good about campus violence and all that, but there's also the campus safety, the fact of, you know, conditions of service at the college, whether it's especially to get towards winter and snow removal and all that, so definitely something to be on the lookout for. But other than that, Mr. Speaker, I have nothing else to do. Thank you.
All right, thank you. Now we'll review item 10, appointments, resignations, and vacancies. President Smith.
I have two appointments. I'm appointing Megan Fisk to the Public Relations Committee and Leandro Alvarez to the Undergraduate Curriculum Committee. I'm going to read off all the vacancies we have in the committees right now because, as Parliament members, you are all required to join a college committee as well as an SEG committee, and most of you have not joined a college committee. You know who you are, and I know who you are. So our vacancies read as such. We have spots open on academic affairs, bylaws, conditions and services, elections. In fact, I believe the only full committee is the non-parliament side of our finance committee, but we still have student parliament seats on finance. We have spots available on the PEC. We have many spots available in public relations, the SEC, SOC, which is Gloria's committee. And for college committees, we have RIT Council, the Committee on Academic Advising, Committee on Academic Policies and Procedures, Academic Standing, the Calendar Committee, the Committee on College Lectures, Committee on College Mission and Goals, the General Education Committee, PFAC, which is the Performing Fine Arts. Actually, you guys can go on that twice on PowerPoint. Never mind, forget I said that. Student Conduct Board, Student Design Board, and Concentration Subcommittee. We need more people on the Committee on Student Life, another member of Traffic and Parking, and two members for Vision 2020, which is a five-year plan for the college. I'd like to remind everyone again that you all have to join an SEG committee and a college committee, and we're expecting you all to sign up in the office. With that, I'd just like to remind everyone one more time before we conclude for the night that the declaration period for deputy speakers can be November 17th through December 1st in the office upstairs.
All right,
that's all, Mr. Speaker. I'd like these appointments to be approved with unanimous.
Are there any objections to the President's appointments? Hearing none, the appointments are approved. Would you also like to propose that we accept the Deputy Speaker's resignation of Speaker Brett?
Yes.
All right, would you like to make a formal motion?
Motion.
By motion by President Smith to accept Deputy Speaker Prisoco's resignation with deep regret, second by Representative Fisk. Discussion hearing none. All those in favor of accepting the resignation with deep regret, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, no. Abstentions. And the Deputy Speaker Prisoco abstains. And the resignation is accepted with deep regret. And does that conclude? Now move to item 11, issues of polling numbers. Please raise your cards high and keep them up if you have issues. Representative Krell, we'll start with you.
Yes, so at the end of every parliament meeting, I see people take their water bottles or take their materials from the meetings and they just put them in the trash. And I think a simple change that we can all do is to just walk 10 feet over and put them in the recycling. So I'd just like to bring that to everyone's attention.
Representative Kerr.
This is something I forgot to mention last meeting, but I was actually the 10,000th bottle of saves at our SCG water filling station right down the hall. So I'm reusing mine. Hopefully we'll reuse your bottles as well.
Any more issues with all members? Hearing none. There's only one motion still in order, and that is a motion to adjourn. We have a motion to adjourn. Representative Rosario, second by Representative Hurd. No discussion. All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, no. Abstentions, and we are adjourned. Please stay seated and silent for roll call.
Robert Smith.
Here.
Lorenzo Kasnick.
Here.
Lori Cepeda. Here. Noah Carson.
Here.
Thomas Lima.
Here.
Brittany Prisoco.
Here.
Leandro Alvarez. Gilbert Carreras. Shane Crowley.
Here.
Megan Fisk.
Here.
Connor Gerlach.
Here.
Corey Soriga.
Here.
Emma Holman.
Here.
Patrick Kirk.
Here.
Josh Lulock. Linda Lynn. Logan Roush. Jose Rosario.
Here.
Ben Salahaney.
Here.
Derek Cromley. Jason Windrow.
Here.
Scott Cade.
Here.
Michelle Brophy-Bierman. Mark Paolucci. Robert Santori.
Here.
Good night, guys.